I was getting bored.
Bill Leonard or Ian Brew? Leonard getting the jump. So the first one, Bill Leonard is car number 28.
Boy, the number 11 car.
Number
3 car trying to get into the lead. Cassidy all the way up to third. Now Curry, he goes back to fifth.
Nobody can take advantage of a restart.
Kenny is running.
And right now,
wow, three wide. Boy. How about Corey, man? He's digging.
Do
you think Kenny gonna reel him in?
Sean
Carey. Bill Leonard definitely did not want that.
It's side by side for the lead. Look at this, folks. We're in the turn number three. Your leader is by a ton. It's just Ken Cassidy Jr.
And oh boy.
All over him like a body cap.
Same three cars. Boy.
Getting the nose of his car underneath water. Now he drops off the pace temporarily. Throw is a factor along with Burrow, but it's an old fashioned.
Kenny got the lead though, huh?
Between Bill Leonard and Ken Cassidy.
How long does Ken Cassidy last up and down the
line?
Boy, if he can keep that car from bobbing and weaving on him, Bill Leonard.
Here comes Ray Ray.
Against the number 93, Ray Christian, the third, car number 20, currently running.
All right, we had a show for a while there. Not right down to the wire, but we'll take it.
and the Overdrive 300 winner in the mini stock division is Ted Katzen Jr. A great run for that car. 93 takes home second spot.
Nice job, brother. You got $5?
Yeah, in the trailer.
You think this stuff is free? Nice job, my man.
Thanks,
nice job. You got a dollar or something?
I think that's all you need for this right now.
Nice job, man.
Finishing in third in quite a helter-skelter race, here is Wade Burrows. Wade, a lot of people are losing their handling. How are you able to maintain yours?
Car is actually getting better the longer we ran. Those cautions are actually killing us. Seems like the longer we run the freer the car got, it was helping us out the freer tight from the beginning.
Ray Christian III. It looked like you were doing the 11 car all he could handle at about 10 to go. Then he started to pull away at the end. What was going on inside that number 93 car?
The car was really fast on the short run. Just as the race went on, it just got tighter and tighter. I mean, those cautions helped out, but I thought I was able to get underneath the billy there, but we just ran out. It just got tight, so it's a good race.
You know, with about 30 or 20 laps to go, we thought you were driving as hard as you could, and then you kept on driving even harder than that.
Oh yeah, I was driving hard for a whole 50 laps. You see me draw number 10 earlier, so we had to come from the back. A lot of fast cars in front of us, so you know, 50 lap race, kind of bided my time, took a week ago, and we had some big relay today.
Do you have somewhere to put this?
We'll take out a 4. So that means that Randy Churchill will be starting on the pole. How surprised were you to win your first pole ever?
Very. I timed out a couple times before and I was terrible. I missed terrible practice and I went out there and
set
fast time and I'm very excited.
Car 09.
I know the 37 was also involved in that somewhat, but he came out unscathed. Also, the 88 came out unscathed. So.
You all right, driver? Get away. You okay?
Yeah.
Where are you going? Hey, thanks a lot, asshole! Back over with your car so we know where to take it. Randy, you all right? Heads up.
Hey, Corey! Corey!
Okay, what do we get in? Come on out there, Slim.
Try it. Yeah, hey, sorry for yelling at you, bud. They just told me what happened.
Yeah, no problem.
Sorry for yelling at you, bud.
I'm just going to try something
to piss. I am too.
Watch yourself. Oh boy. Oh, Glenn Griswold gonna throw it in here or what? What's Buckford call him? The old war horse or something? Going through.
Yesterday, I feel like we can win at the bowl tomorrow. We're here.
Well, you take an old engine, and you add an old warhorse, you put the two together,